Michael Miner set to do battle against the Chicago Badass Rockstone. That should be a great matchup. And we have the brackets revealed to crown new COH Tag Team Champions. We'll be seeing those brackets in a few short, well, after this matchup, we're going to go through the entire card. I didn't think we'd start opening matchups so early here tonight. We're wasting no time. Let's see what this man has made up here in a few short moments. So we're going to be bringing on his opponent. He said a few words on our last episode, and he's also making his in-ring debut here tonight on Rage. There he is. Who's a hoe? He a hoe? He a big hoe. I guess that's who he's going to be getting in the ring with. He is a big man. Billy Ray Dog is in the house. This should be quite an interesting matchup. Two men who I've never called a matchup either of theirs before. Well, that's going to be changing in a few short moments. As I mentioned, you know, we have a main event, Michael Miner versus Rockstone here on main event tonight. In our last episode, during the closing moments of Rage, we saw the surprise return of Kevin Cross. Fans, I'm not sure if Kevin Cross is here tonight. I haven't seen him backstage. But as soon as if I hear any updates, you'll be the first to know. You'll be hearing it from me. I don't know if Kevin's here tonight. Maybe he'll say something tonight. Maybe he'll say something else. He's going to say something. It's just a matter of when and where. Kevin Cross making showing his face on the last episode of Rage. Champion, we're starting this matchup. Here we go. You already see the size difference between these two men. Oh, God. And Sundance already. Already? Oh, my goodness! Already taking this fight to the outside. I don't like this at all. Headbutt there from Billy Ray Dog. Now put around that arm of Sundance. Ray Dog got lucky. You get paralyzed there from that belly to back suplex on the outside. Wait a minute. Oh my goodness. And Sundance lucky he didn't have a broken nose there. Oh, Jesus, now they're coming in front of me. This is only an opening contest here, fans. We still got plenty more action coming your way. I mean, we're already getting things started. My goodness. Both men throwing each other everywhere on the outside. They better get back inside the ring. They don't want to risk getting counted out.
Seven.
Oh, my God. Referee on seven count. Oh. Nice power slam there.
Nine.
Man. 20 counts here in COH fans. So these guys have another 10 seconds, another 10 long seconds to get back into the ring. They're lucky, otherwise this one would have been over toward the islands. Oh my God!
11.
I'm surprised his shoulder didn't get separated there. I mean, his shoulder hit that bottom of those steel steps.
13.
Referee on a 13 count. Sundance breaking up that count. Now referee's got to start over again. Drop kick there. The big man still ain't going down. I mean, the size difference is really a make or break here so far. Billy Ray was able to get him down on his feet. They had to throw him those steel steps.
Four.
Finally, both men get back into the ring. And now Sundance. DDT! Wait a minute. Look at Billy Ray Dog getting back on his feet there. With Sundance, he didn't like that. He gives him a second one. And Billy Ray Dog refuses to stay down. That's going to be pissing off Sundance. Wait a minute. Wait, what's this? DDT of his own there with that reverse. He now comes to the top turnbuckle here. Sundance, what's this? Crossbot, oh boy. Look at that, Sundance and just slams him down with that scoop slam. Sundance, oh my goodness. Now just choking all the air out of Billy Ray Dog. Now just pounding away on the skull there. Jesus. Is that slap really necessary at the end there? There. Bailey. Oh, moonsault. Nice springboard moonsault there from Mr. Ray Dog. And now, down to those ropes. Elbow there from Sundance. Sundance is so big, he can't even squeeze in between the ropes. What's this now? Oh! He goes down that time! Here we go! Here we go! This could do it! That's two! No! No way, Jose! We are not there yet! What's this? I think they're going through the floor there. He's too close to the ropes. Ray Dog doing everything he has to throw at Sundance. Why not get that double on their debut? Man, and just driving those knees right to the stomach. Kick there from Sundance. Ooh, nice chop. Ducks that kick. Duck that one. Duck the chop. And a big clothesline to take him down. Billy Ray Dog getting back on his feet here. Elbow there. And a big spear. Big spear taking down the big man. There on Sundance. Big Dog now. What's this? Hey, man, he's got him up. There's the pile driver. This could do it. Billy Ray Dog dragging him, getting away from those ropes. He got a rope break before when he had that inverted figure four. Doesn't want to repeat. Only getting two. Only got two from that pile driver. Dogs, woof, 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 down with the super kick. picking up the victory in his debut matchup here tonight on Rage. Now Paul Drummond with the beginning of the end for Sundance. Take another look there from the second angle. And the Great Dog only getting a two count there. And bam, that super kick. Laid him out for good and got the three count. Sundance has unfortunately taken L tonight here on Rage. Congratulations to that man, Billy Ray Dog, on winning his debut matchup here in Call of Honor. But fans, we're just getting this one started. We're just getting warmed up. This is just a red carpet. This is our opening premiere. We're just getting started here in COH. We still got plenty more action coming your way. Firestar Hart will be also making his COH return against Justin Massacre. That should be a solid one matchup. Also, Levi McIntyre, the War Machine, will be in action here again against Christian Everett. War Machine will be doing battle against Mr. Everett. Also, El Novino is going to get another shot here tonight. Going up against the undefeated Trey Jeter. That should be quite an interesting high-flying contest. And as I mentioned, our main event here tonight, Michael Minor. Vicious, mean Michael Minor will be going up against the Chicago Badass Rockstone. We see our brackets here to crown our first ever COH Tag Team Champions. We start our first of the quarterfinals there on our bottom right, the corner of the Emerald City All-Stars. Will be doing battle against the Sea Boys. Here we go. We're starting our second contest right now, as I mentioned. Our first quarterfinal matchup to crown the new COH Tag Team Champions. We got Patrick C wearing the hoodie. We got Louis C with the glasses and the hat. The C Boys. Now the rules of this tag team matchup, these will be normal tag team rules. These are not tornado style rules. Only one man from each team will be inside the ring. You gotta tag your partners for them to be the legal man. First team to pick up a pinfall submission or knockout wins. Knockouts aren't something we see every day here at Call of Honor, but they can happen. Here come their opponents. Tenacious B, James H. Steele, the Emerald City All-Stars. Rocking the pink here on Rage. Don't know who's wearing that like a face mask, almost like a ski mask sorts. JSH Steel, he's the moonsault machine. So expect to see a lot of moonsaults here tonight. This is the second time we've seen them in tag team action on COH, right? They had their debut matchup. They were successful. They can keep that train going. I mean, the Sea Boys really need a victory here because they haven't had a good run so far here in Rage. Here we go. James H. Steele, Patrick C. starting this one off. Look at this. A backbreaker there from Steele. Steele already wasting a little time. Going to the top turnbuckles. Oh, man. I think he's doing this a little too early. Oh! Nice! Great ring awareness there from James H. Steele. He saw Patrick C. got down, is able to take him out. Patrick C. didn't like that too much. That's a clothesline. Steele hanging on. It's the second one. He is still hanging on, not letting go. Bam! Third time's a charm. Steel and kick there. What's this? What the hell? Oh! Nice takedown there from Mr. Steel. He makes a tag to Tenacious B. Yeah. What's this now? Chop right away from Patrick. Should go from there. And now, oh, he takes Tenacious B to the outside. Tenacious B, a little rough landing there for him. stepping on that leg there, Tanisha. Ouch, that's got him. No water to pull there for Patrick C. Really gets taken down by Tanisha B. Quick shot, come on, they always got it pulled up to the table in front of me. Stop that crap. I like my table. Be knocked down the outside. Gabe Patrick C, the opportunity to make the tag to Lewis C. To the top, here we go, and there's a double foot stomp. Here, jeesh, I'm getting two. Tenacious B, taking his attention. Oh, just takes out Patrick Siegel, right back to the legal man. What's this? Oh, nice. Tenacious B shows no mercy. James Steele, not a legal man again. There we go. Another leg lock here from James H. Steele. Meanwhile, Tenacious B is going to set his focus on Patrick C, who's still very hurt from his attack. Oh, man. Now we're going to get some fighting both in and outside of the ring. There. Looks like he was trying to go for a DDT. Lewis C putting on the brakes. Lewis C, there's the face. A little sting of the scorpion there. Oh my goodness. Face buster there. Lewis, that's a, ooh, again, not even getting two. Team's kicking out at one. There's a drop kick. Down goes James Steele. Lewis C makes it tag to Patrick. Now we're back to the original two men that started this match off. What the hell is Patrick C doing? Looks like he got. Oh! Tenacious B saw it coming. Insult there from Patrick. Looks like the chaos on the outside is going to continue here. Wait a minute. And Lewis C, he's going after Tenacious B. Rolling continues here, fans. Lewis, oh my goodness. Patrick C driving the knees right to the back. Now just stomping away here on James Steele. And Tenacious B looks like he's back on his feet. He's getting back in the ring here. This matchup's gonna get pretty chaotic. I can feel it. This overwhelms. Wait a minute, Tenacious. Oh my goodness, right in front of me, fans! And a big boot there for Patrick. There we go. Two. Only getting two. And another one, Jesus. Steele's not looking too good here. See, stomping away. Looks like both men are getting back into each other's corners. We gotta control some of this chaos. There's the Shockmaster there from Patrick. Only getting two. God, what elbows there from Patrick. Shot there from Steele. Steele now. Oh, there's that same move again he did earlier. Is this now? Wait. Oh, nice nice reversal there from Patrick. Looks like he's going for a choke slam of some sorts. Now, takes Steele to his corner. Elbow there from Steele. That's an uppercut. Knocked him a little dizzy there. Oh, man. Sends his face right to the corner. Oh, kick there to the face. James Steele. There's the moonsault machine. And he's not done. He's going for a second one. And third time's a charm. He's going up, up, up. Up, 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 and away. Damn. He got him. And the referee's claiming this one's a knockout. As I mentioned, I mean, pinfall submission or knockout. We don't see that every day. But James Steele's able to knock out Patrick C with his triple moonsault. They don't call him the moonsault machine for nothing. And that shockmaster there from Patrick C. I thought that would have been possibly the end there, or at least the beginning of the end for James Steele. Even taking all those elbows to the face, he still found a way to come back into this one. And as you see, this is our finishing finale here. There's triple moonsault there from the moonsault machine, James Steele. I mean, and Patrick was so dizzy as it was. I mean, the referee stopped this match just for the sake of the man's health. And just like that, the Emerald City All-Stars are moving on into the semifinals of this tag team tournament. Oh my God, these guys are ridiculous. Fans, you still got to play Meraxi coming your way. Stay tuned.
Stand by on 12. 3,
we're gonna hit you 2, 1, music, mic, cure.
Extreme!
Defeating the Sea Boys to head into the semifinals. And I thought we were going to kick off our next contest here, but instead, here's Jeffrey Albritton. It's the first time we've seen Albritton since his title matchup against Stefan Guerrero. Unfortunately, he was unsuccessful in defeating the CRH World Champion, all thanks to his rival seems like Michael Miner. What the hell is what is up with that guy? What the hell's his problem? What is his beef with Jeffrey Albritton? They had a 1-1 matchup on Rage a while back, and the match ended in a disqualification when Miner used a chair on Jeffrey Albritton. I mean, was Miner upset because he didn't capture the Pride Championship and he took his anger out of Jeffrey? I don't know. I don't know what's going on. Maybe Jeffrey, I mean, he's not scheduled to wrestle here tonight. Maybe Jeffrey's going to try to get to the bottom of this as well. Well, he's asking for a microphone. Oh, he's got one. All right, let's hear what's on the mind of Mr. Albritton.
6.5 years. It took me 6.5 years to get a singles championship opportunity. But not just a singles championship. The singles championship. The championship that's been held by some of the most all-time COH greats. AJ Young, Mason Chronic, Justin Bateman, Kevin Cross, Immaculacy, and so on and so forth. See, Jeffrey Albritton was this close to be added onto that list. But see, here's the thing. a little distraction, a little pest by the name of Michael Midcard Miner, who still we don't know what his intentions are. Because up until now, we haven't heard a word one from him. Like, what's the point? Was it because that I'm a bigger star than you? Is it because that I won more championships than you? What is it? Are you jealous of me? Are you jealous that within your time in COH, you have yet to be in the main event? Matter of fact, the last, like, Wage 3, that was the closest that you have came to a wrestling in the main event. That's the closest that you're ever going to fucking get. Think about that for a second. If you're going to hit me, I'm going to hit you where it hurts. See, Michael, you're just a mid-card guy. And you're just going to have to accept it. You're pretty much wrestling in leagues that are a little bit too deep for you. Hell, Shock Nation Wrestling, you were lucky that that company basically gave you the time of day to even compete in the main event. But see, here in COH, that's a little bit different. See, this is where legends are made. You want to call yourself a legend, you're going to have to work a little harder than that, buddy. But see, you'll never make it there. At least not on my watch, you're not. See, like I said on social media, you're going to pay in blood for what you've done. You cost me a chance to be the face of COH. And you are going to pay. Oh, I'm going to make sure you're going to pay. Management, I would protect this guy at all costs. If I get my hands on him, it's on sight. Just know that, Michael Miner, it's on fucking sight!
Oh, shit. Wait a minute, you say his name three times in a mirror, he will appear! Michael Miner! Jeffrey warned them, it's on sight, here we go! I mean, Miner is still... We're expecting him to compete here in a main event tonight. I mean, that's if Jeffrey O'Brien lets him compete in a main event. If he makes it out of this brawl, referee, we have to send some people out here. Oh my, here we go! Oh my goodness! It's a slugfest! And here comes the referee and our security staff trying to break this fight up, but they can! Oh my god! Fans, we gotta go to another break. We'll be back. Stay tuned.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a.
We're gonna do it.
Give us any chance, we'll take it.
Troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name.
All week with you. These days are ours. Shell and the green.
Welcome back, fans. During our break, we're able to, our security staff were able to separate All Britain and Michael Minor. Michael Minor is still going to be competing in our main event here tonight. So you haven't seen the last of him. Happening right now, we have another 1-on-1 matchup. El Novino will be going up against Trey Jeter, the undefeated Trey Jeter. Novino was unsuccessful in our last episode when he took an L to Austin Logan. And Austin Logan is going to be competing in our tag team tournament. He's not scheduled to compete here tonight, but we will be seeing him in action in the near future. We're going to see if El Novino can possibly end this little winning streak that Trey Jeter has been on since our first episode of Rage. McIntyre, War Machine, still going to be in action here tonight against Christian Everett. And Firestar Hart will be making his COH in-ring return when he takes on Justin Massacre. And here it comes. Here he is. The undefeated Trey Jeter. Continue, I'd like to give my condolences to Mr. Billy Way Grant, who's also, many people may know him in the call community as Blade Wyatt. He has unfortunately passed away over a week ago, the airing of this episode. You know, and we'd like to give our condolences to all of his family and friends on mourning over his death. Blade Wyatt never had the opportunity to compete in the series, but he is a member of our call community. And see, we would like to give his condolences to Blade Wyatt and his family. Rest easy, my friend. We're about to start this 1-on-1 matchup here. Jeter and Novino. Both high-flying wrestlers. Both wrestlers who like to fly high. They like to reach for the sky, as they say. Jeter, obviously, he has a size advantage over Novino. Look at this. Great, just tossing Novino around. And ooh, stomping right on that arm. Jeter, as I mentioned, he likes to fly. He's going to the top turnbuckle. He's calling out Novino. What's this? Ooh, Novino stepping out of the way. He just slid his body to the side. And oh, moonsault. Going for the pinfall. Here we go. Ooh, only getting one count. Novino, moonsault right to the spine. Again, he's going for another cover. Second cover here. One, two. Oh, he got another second out of it. First time was one, the second time he got two. Maybe one more moonsault, he'll get the three. Or a possible knockout. That's what we're witness to over here. And we're going to Vino. Got the advantage on Jeter. With that submission hold here. Wait a minute. Oh. Oh, man. Jeter kicking his way out of that one. And there's a knee to the face. Second one. Yes, hits him again. Third time's a charm. No, no, no. He got a little greedy there. Should have stopped after that second one. There's his face. Over there from Novino. Missing that knee. Now, Jeter. Suplex. hanging on. Possibly a Three Amigos here. Wait, no. Back suplex. Double suplex combination. Now, what's this? Nice moonsault. Only getting a two count there. Solid back and forth matchup between us. 2 minutes! Jeter comes in with the knee that time. A little payback there. Nice lock. Elbow there. To those ropes. Elbow there. What the hell's Drew Jeter got in mind? Oh my goodness! A DDT there. Right on the ring apron. Back kick. He's taking down Lovino. Let me get up. I don't want to get too close to this action. Oh man! Back into the ring. For now. What's this? Oh my gosh! Look at that! A standing C4! I call it a Spanish fly, but I don't think Trey Jeter's Hispanic. What's this? Yeah! The director's cut! This could do it! There's the three! Just like that! Trey Jeter defeats El Novino, and he continues his undefeated streak here on Rage. I mean, he can hit that director's cut from anytime, anywhere, and he hit it quickly and was able to put down El Novino. Fans, we still got plenty more action coming your way, but coming up next, we're gonna hear a few words from our pride champion, the one, Mark Kennedy. Stay tuned.
Hello, everybody in the COH universe. As everyone saw, I defended my pride championship on the latest episode of Rage and walked out victorious, even though I got busted open. And that's gonna keep happening, because you know what? I am a fighting champion. I will defend my title against whoever management sees fit to face me. Because I want to not only be the best Pride champion, but one of the longest reigning Pride champions here in COH. And that's what I'm going to do. I will accomplish that goal one way or the other. I also gotta say, rest in peace to one of the greatest tag team wrestlers, in my opinion, of all time. That's just my opinion, because I've seen this man wrestle live before. Reach for the sky, Jay Briscoe. Your family, I am so sorry for their loss. I am so sorry for everybody's loss. But you're in my thoughts, my prayers. Your family forever will be. Reach for the sky, Jay. People will see you again. And when they do, you'll be putting on those classics, just like you did down here. I'll see everybody on the next episode of Rage. No matter if it's just a promo or I defend my championship, I will see everybody soon.
Welcome back here, fans. We're starting our next contest. Here comes Justin Massacre. Justin Massacre, he made his COH debut competing in that four-corner survival matchup we had on Rage a while back. Unfortunately, he was the one that took the loss, that took the pinfall to Adam Jackpot. Now, tonight he has a chance to redeem himself here. As he goes up against Firestar Hart, Firestar Hart will be making his COH return. So Firestar still has a lot here in COH to prove. Both Firestar and Justin Massacre. They both want to have a longevity career here. As far as I'm concerned, I don't think these two have ever met in the squared circle before, so this will be a first time meeting between these two men. And they get to do it in a COH ring. There he is. Firestar Hart is back inside Call of Honor. The Heavy Metal Rebel is here and he's back. Your current CXWY All-Star Champion, your current CRW Heavyweight Champion, the Devil Saint himself, the Devil Saint Trigger, Firestar Hart. And the Deadly Saints are on their feet for this man. Firestar Hart has a second chance to redeem himself here in Call of Honor. This is a reset button here in COH, which means it's a reset button for this man. Unfortunately, saw his former tag team partner, El Novino, get defeated by Trey Jeter. No suit. I mean, Novino and Firestar have teamed up for a little bit here in COH. Look at that, the code of honor between both of these men. That's something you don't see every day here in COH, a code of honor, a handshake. Usually we do that before or after the match, but here we go. The bell rings, let's do it. Firestar now. Oh my god! Suplex into a backbreaker already. Look at this, the Anaconda Vice from Firestar. Is he going to end this one early? The Massacre able to knee his way out of it. Irish whip. Goes into the corner. Knee there from Firestar. Oh, man going back and forth and a big kick to the face. Firestar up with the top turnbuckle here. It's this. Oh! Knees up on that red arrow. And hope Black Cannonball. No water to pull. What the hell is this? Firestar now. Here we go. Try to go for the moonsault. But the knees go up again. He did this in the four-way matchup. Oh! Wow, 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 wee, that's gotta hurt. Jesus. Working on that leg there, Firestar. What in the hell? Deliver multiple headbutts there. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Going back to the leg again, Justin Massacre. He's pounded away. What's this now? There it is. Throws all his weight right across his chest. Massacre, he's not done. Oh, knee there to the gut. Here we go. Getting a two count. Massacre now. Oh my goodness. Yeah, release powerbomb. I guess that's what you would call it. Firestar's got him up on his shoulders. Right. He drops his face right out of that top turnbuckle. There, down goes Firestar again. Here we go. Again, throws all his weight right across his chest. Finally gets the cannonball. There's water in the pool. Hey, again? Oh no, Firestar puts the knees up. Big double front kick there. Firestar, there's the moonsault. Stomping away. Oof. Kick there to the face. Firestar now. He's got Massacre right where he wants him. Now looking on the wrist. Ooh. Rob Chan break his fingers. What's this? Oh. Snapdragon suplex there. Firestar. There's DDT. Elevation really got him all the way up there. Over there from Massacre. Oh my, wow, what a DDT! Jesus! Dropped Firestar straight on his skull. Wait a minute, Massacre now. There's the super kick! Now he's calling for the end. Oh boy, he's got him up. What is he gonna go for here? Reversal there for Firestar! In a German suplex! He's got him up! He's got him up! Oh! Nice rolling cutter there! And now Firestar went to the top turnbuckle here. He's calling up Massacre. Massacre not looking too good. Oh! Try to go for a spinning heel kick. Massacre moved out of the way. Shot there to the face. Firestar! Oh my god! Tries to hit right to the canvas with that springboard DDT! He takes Justin to the corner. Now, wait a minute. Firestar! He's got Massacre! He's got him! There's the one winged angel! That could do it! He gets the three! This matchup here. A solid back and forth matchup. A back and forth contest. And there it is. That was the end right there. That one wing angel onto Justin Massacre is able to get the three count. And Firestar Hart wins his big return matchup here in Call of Honor. Now the heavy metal gods are very impressed with what they've just seen here from Firestar Hart. Fans, coming up next, we're going to be hearing from another superstar who's going to be making his debut soon here on Rage. Let's hear from Mr. Joe Rivers.
You know, in the long, long career that I have had, you see, I thought I'd done it all. But in reality, I really haven't. I've only seemed to tip the iceberg or reached just below the surface. But in 2023, I will again make it the year of Joe Rivers. I will again be on top of that mountain. And ladies and gentlemen, as much as you all have been begging me to be here, I'm finally here. Call of Honor, my name is Joe Rivers, and I'm here. We'll be right back.
Welcome back, fans. We're starting our next matchup here. Here comes the War Machine, Levi McIntyre. Speaking of the heavy metal gods, they have another follower of theirs. That is the War Machine. As of lately, the War Machine Levi has been having his eyes set on a former old rival of his, Carl Jams, your current COH Internet Champion. It's very simple. Levi wants that title. He says he wants all the gold here in COH since he made his return. He's starting with the Internet Championship. Of course, that opportunity is not going to just be handed to him. He's got to earn it. You got to earn your way here. COH. Tonight he's going up against a man he's never faced before, Christian Everett. There he is.
Stop!
I hope James is watching this matchup closely. body part he can at Levi just to keep him down. Picks up the W tonight here on Rage. And I hope our internet champion is watching that matchup closely, because that showdown is going to be happening very soon, and that hopefully that's not the outcome Jams is going to want. Fans, coming up next, we're going to be hearing from the All-American, the Patriot. Look at Levi McIntyre. We've seen the code of honor earlier tonight, and there it is again. Levi being a sport there. Both men had a great back and forth match, but as I mentioned, we're going to be hearing from the Patriot next. We're going to be talking about the events that happened between him and Justin Bateman. Wait a minute. Speaking of Carl Jams, there he is. There's our Pride champion. Oh, I can't wait for this matchup to happen. I can't wait!
You know, I had an epiphany. I had to think about this. On Rage 3, I was at first insulted at the idea that Justin Bateman would deny me of my request. Would deny me of my request to team with him. And then him going out there and calling me a coward, that was really offensive to me because I am anything but a coward. But that's beside the point. I sat there, I was offended. But now that I've actually had a chance to absorb what was said on that rage, what I had to take in, I'm actually pretty happy that he declined my offer. I'm actually grateful that he declined my offer because Bateman, let's just take the cat out of the bag, okay? You are nothing more than a liar. You are nothing more than a hypocrite, okay? You want to sit there and say that my flaunting of my accomplishments, which are much better than yours, is somehow not affecting you in any way and that you can accept that I'm better than you? That's not true. That is simply not true. Because in that same speech that you spewed out in front of me with all the vomit, with all of the un-American vomit from Pakistan or from Yugoslavia, where the hell you're from, you are back because you're addicted to that audience, that you're addicted for this. You do want to become better than me. And it's proof in the pudding because you want to team up with that lunatic over there, Immaculacy. You claimed at Last Dance that you want to win the COH tag team titles. You clearly want to get the better of someone like myself, who is much better than you. But here's the thing, Mr. Bateman. I knew somebody that didn't care if he won a world title, if he won the pride title, if he won the television title, the tag title, whatever title exists in this company. I knew somebody personally. You want to know his name? His name was The Amazing Punk. And The Amazing Punk was a good friend of mine. A very good friend of mine. Despite our little falling out in 2016, believe it or not, at Last Dance, I got to see him. And we shook hands. This was probably going to be the last time that we were going to face each other, because he had retired from this industry. The stuff I had seen him do, the stuff that I'd seen him do, despite everybody having fun at his promo skills, the guy didn't care. He had fun. He had fun. He was just happy to be in front of that audience. He was having fun every single day, walking through that curtain, running through that ramp, going into that ring, and having the roar of the crowd. That was a man that was just happy to be given an opportunity to entertain. Me and Carl Jams brought him into our faction, and he became something more. He became something relevant, much more than some of the people here that won titles. And obviously, as you saw in the last rage, he passed away. He was a very good man. That was a man that didn't care. That was a man that was just happy to be here. That was a man that was just privileged at the idea that he got an opportunity. Not you. You're a guy that likes to flaunt around his legacy. You're the guy that wants to pick up on his legacy because he knew that he was a one-trick pony. And now that you rejected my offer, I'm glad. I'm glad because I had an actual thought. A real intelligent thought. And the intelligent thought is that I don't want you to be my partner. No. I actually want you to be my opponent. The all-American, American-American, the American reality himself versus the American psycho, Mr. Huey Lewis in the news, Mr. Power of Love himself, going back to the future so that he can redeem what's left, except that he doesn't have it. So how about it? The Patriot versus Justin Bateman. But we'll do it in the biggest show, the first CPV of the Rage era, Patriot Justin Bateman. And then we'll see who really is the coward. Can you take it, Justin Bateman? I don't think so. Because the All-American, American-American, is going to put you down in the name of the greatest, number 45, himself, Daddy Trump. We are going to put you down. American Psycho, more like an American Failure.
To worship it, what a price is it getting? Touch yourself, don't touch yourself. Better ways to protect your health. I got prices to waste and spill. I got promises to die to kill. Touch yourself, don't touch yourself. Now, now, now. I wanna run up in line. I think I want it in time. Now I'm in line, so tell you what I'm gonna do. I got nothing to lose, I got nothing to lose. Know that I'm not having fun. Ain't no more talking and smiling. Cause you know I won't get out of my mind. This is the way without this.
Start our main event. We like to take back to what happened in our closing moments on our last episode of Rage. A masked hoodie man approached the ring, approached Jenna McAleese, and it turned out to be Kevin Cross, the returning Kevin Cross here on Rage. We haven't heard from Kevin Cross at all. Hopefully we'll hear something from him in our next show. But we got a main event matchup starting right now. Michael Minor against the Chicago Badass Rockstone. Let's get this bad boy going. Rage 3, our main event was Jeffrey Albritton finally receiving his first ever shot at the World Championship against Stefan Guerrero. And thanks to a little help from Michael Myers, Stefan was able to retain his World Championship. But after that, the aftermath, Rockstone came out and laid out our World Champion, laid out Stefan Guerrero. Rockstone did win that 40-something Honor Rumble match back at the Last Dance, so he is still eligible for a shot at the World Championship. It looks like he's got his mind set on Stefan Guerrero's world title. Tonight he's going to have quite an interesting opponent. A man who also competed in that 40-something Honor Rumble was Michael Minor. Minor seems to always be pissed off whenever we see him on screen. He's always pissed. What is it with that guy? Earlier in the show, him and Jeffrey Albritton had a little slugfest, but luckily our COH side was able to break up that fight. Here he comes.
Oh,
motherfucking Michael Myers.
That's right. Look at him.
Probably the most meanest and most unhappy son of a bitch we have here in COH. And he's in our main event here tonight on Rage. And I'm not sure where Jeffrey Alpert is right now. I'm pretty sure he's probably still backstage, maybe. Unless he's storming out the arena. I don't know. I really don't know. We haven't seen Jeffrey since the minor had that brawl. I haven't had any updates on him. I mean, he didn't get hurt or anything. I don't know where he is. He's got to be watching this matchup. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's playing for the Chicago Badass here. Nice brain buster. Stomping away. Look at those stomps. Right to the chest of Miner. Caught that foot. Tried to screw there. What's this now? Oh! Rams that knee right across the face. Nice help. Facebuster there. Rockstone going to the top here. Wasting no time. That's the Chicago Badass going for. Oh, and he got the elbow. I don't know if he got all of it, but he got some of it though. A Miner with a facebuster of his own. Oh, elbow to the face. It takes out the Chicago Badass and drives that knee. He's going for a second one. And there's a second knee. Now Miner's going to the top. Is he going to do an elbow of his own? Miner! No! Try to drop the knees. Rockstar moved out of the way. Rockstone's defense here, just staying on top of Miner. Brown wants to see Miner's fingers get broken, and I don't blame him. I want to see his fingers get broken too. Oh, and a knee there to the face. Miner, he's got Rockstone. Oh, right on those ropes. Wait a minute, and Rockstone! The Miner put a brakes at Rockstone's offense there. I guess not. He's gonna have to do more damage than that. Rockstone, a former COH Pride champion. Coming in with those elbows.
head. I think that one busted open Rockstone. We got blood in our main event here. Taking Rockstone to the corner. Oh, and a knee there right to the head. Damn. Look at this. A sleeper hold there to the Chicago Badass. Rockstone to try to put him to sleep. I mean, he got it busted open. All that blood is going to rush to his head and more. And it's just going to come flowing out of his forehead like a freaking water fountain. And then, oh! Rockstone able to break his way out of it. Rockstone now. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Oh my God, what a lariat!
Bent him inside out. Only getting two from it though. I mean, Rockstone hit the right move that he needed to hit, but unfortunately he didn't get the three count. He's got to continue staying on top of Minor. Ooh. Nice clothesline. Close up Minor. It's this now. Samson's face right into that turnbuckle. Rockstone, what's this? Oh my God! He just freaking tossed Minor to the outside. Rockstone, what's he gonna go for here? He's got five! Look at that! Nice! Rockstone taking out Michael Minor there. Two count. Rockstone's got Minor up on his shoulders. What is he going to go for here? Powerbomb on the ring apron? Possibly not. Minor able to break out of it. Wait a minute. Minor, he's got Rockstone. What's this? Oh my God! Feast your eyes on that knee. Looks like Minor's going to try to win this one by count out. He don't care. As long as he picks up the W, he don't care how he does it. Pinfall, submission, knockout, or count out. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Oh no. Oh no. What the hell is he doing here? Savant Guerrero, a world champion, is here. The Incan Emperor is in the building. Come on. Look at this, Rockstone can grab in that chair. Rockstone, you can't get distracted by, look at, oh no. That's just what Safon wanted to, but only got a two count there from Minor. He was just going for that distraction. Safon Guerrero, he's still on the entranceway, just watching this matchup. Minor. Holds Rockstone. Uh-oh. Looks like Minor's going to possibly fly here? No, he comes in with that drop kick. Michael Myers sees that steel chair. This is how he freaking put away Jeffrey Albritton when they first had their encounter. I don't think he cares if he gets disqualified. He's gonna do it again. Rockstone, beware, man. Wait a minute. Rockstone! Nice! Oh no. Savant Guerrero now. He's now coming down. Look at Rockstone. He's waiting for him. Rockstone cannot get distracted. He's got to stay focused in this matchup. Miner's getting back on his feet. Wait a minute. Oh, no! Not again! Rockstone's going to win this one by DQ. But Miner again lives in that chair. Just like he did to Albritton. What's this now? Miner. I mean, this matchup is over. Look at this. Look at this. Come on. And Safon's egging him on to continue the beatdown. Come on. Look at the referee, you gotta stop this. Someone's gotta get it. Stop this. I hate to see our main event end like this, man. It freaking sucks. Look at Safon handing him the chair. He's grabbed another chair. Oh no. Oh man, this isn't looking good. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, it's Albritton. Jeffrey Albritton's back out here. Jeffrey cleans house. Jeffrey making the save for Rockstone. Savant Guerrero, Michael Minor hightailing it out of there. Thank God for Jeffrey. It looks like he never left the building after all. He was watching his match and looks like we all knew something was going to happen. Rockstone showing some love there for Oliver for making the save. Fans, that's going to do it here for the 5th edition of Rage. Oliver Sparkbreaker, thank you for watching Call of Honor. Happy wrestling, everyone.
All right. I've seen enough. I think we all have seen enough from these 5 episodes. This is a return? This is how Call of Honor comes back? This is the quote-unquote new leaf that is turned over? Don't make me laugh. Matter of fact, you couldn't even make me laugh even if you tried. I was told that this was going to be a new direction. I was told that this was a brand new era for this place that was once my home. But lo and behold, what's Travis Sparks doing? Well, I'll tell you, Travis Sparks is doing what Travis Sparks does. He comes out and he makes fake promises, empty promises, lies, fake guarantees, and he comes out and gaslights all of you into believing that this is a, quote, brand new COH, unquote. When in reality, this place is the same scummy, shitty, disgusting place that turned me away from it so long ago. The reason that I walked away from it is still the reason it exists today. Travis, you thought you purged this company? The most toxic person in Call of Honor, in reality, is still here, and that's you. That's M-Accuracy. That's whoever else decided to stay alongside you. Because think about it, Travis. Think about everyone that has left your side. Chris Blaze, Christian Storm, Zane LaFontaine, The Goonie, The Alex Enterprise, Ray Geddes. Where are they? Where are they now? Oh yeah. They're gone because they saw the shit that you were peddling and they got out of there as fast as possible. And then there's people like M-Accuracy and Stefan Guerrero and The Patriot who all stay by you and are loyal COH fighters to the very end. Fools, idiots, morons, disgusting individuals that did nothing to better this company. It was only for themselves, and it was the reason that this place failed all those years ago. And you're thinking that by bringing it back, that people are just gonna forget? That people are just gonna be like, oh, you know, new year, new Travis, right? No, same old Travis, same old COH, same old shit. And you know what? Maybe that's why I came back. Maybe that's why I gravitated back towards Call of Honor. Because this place needs a brutal reminder of what it always has and always will be. My kingdom. I promised you and I told you all those years ago that there was only one constant, one cornerstone of this company, the one thing that'll never change, that's me. Other than your shitty attitude, that is, Travis, me, Caleb Blair, the king. And I'll always be a king. I may have been away from this place for quite some time now. I may have been in the shadows. I may have been a little bit retired. But when something like this is thrust at me, when something like this is thrown in my face, I'm not going to back away or sit here and watch something that I put my blood, sweat, and tears into get degraded into something as humiliating as this. So Travis, I'm gonna save your company, but I'm gonna do it on my terms. And when I come back, everyone is gonna remember exactly who Caleb Blair was. The king is